Now, welcome to the morning call. Equatorial Guinea's vice president and son to the incumbent president, Teodoro Obiang, is in France in absentia, is in France over trial in absentia for looting his impoverished country's millions of euros and purchasing property worth millions of euros abroad. Now, the 47-year-old trial has been described as part of the French government's attempt to maintain its influence in its former colonies and Africa at large. Teodorin, who has previously failed legal efforts rather to stop the trial, is not expected to attend or serve any sentence if he's convicted. Now, he has already been forced by authorities in the United States to forfeit property by which they considered he had bought using corrupt deals.
Teodorin's lawyers call for an adjournment in order to have more time to prepare his client's defense. In short, the conditions not to be met so that the son of the Equatorial Guinean president has a fair trial. Justly, we will raise the issue with the advocate of Teodorin Obiang, Emmanuel Massigny. He speaks to us from Paris.
Qui s'exprime depuis Paris en France. Maître Marcigny, bonjour.
Hello, Marcigny. Is the trial of your client that your client began yesterday, but you pleaded in favor of the postponement. Why? Yes, absolutely. Mr. Nguema has, as everyone knows, lives in the Republic of Equatorial Guinea. French law provides for a minimum period of 2 months for persons residing abroad. Between the time when we are called and the day of meeting, this time limit has not been respected, and therefore we do not recognize the court. And we're asking that this matter be looked into in order to make any legal argument, since Mr. Nguema is not afraid of this trial on the merits, but he must be placed under the conditions of being able to defend himself adequately. He's not pretending to have more rights than another, but he needs not to be treated as if he has less rights.
Mais il ne prétend pas non plus en avoir moins qu'un autre.
Maître Marcigny, on va revenir au procès.
Let us look back to the actual trial. What is the basis of the accusations against Nguema? These charges are based on bank accounts that were obtained illegally in the Republic of Equatorial Guinea, as well as on a few witnesses, mainly political opponents. So on the merits, there is no case, if I may say so. Since these accusations are only accusations which are not backed by any substantive claims. Everything Mr. Nguema does in his country is legal in his country. He must not be prosecuted separately in France. We talk about corruption, but there is no corruption. I have never seen a corruption filed without a bribe. All this is a judicial intellectual construction for purely political ends aimed at destabilizing the political power in place in the Republic of Equatorial Guinea. We know there's a lot of pressure from and a wide media coverage that already seems to condemn your client. Does that not worry you?
Monsieur Obiang Nguema, votre client finalement est condamné de toutes parts. Est-ce que cela vous inquiète?
Listen, in all these highly publicized cases, obviously the role of the press is important, but the law is also important. Where we should worry is when the press influences or comes to influence justice. The press is totally hostile to Nguema. At least that part is not new. Many people write but never go to Equatorial Guinea. They do not know the country. They do not know the rules and its extremely simple equation by saying that there are people who live below the poverty line and on the other hand, their leader buys luxury cars so he is committed a criminal offense. This way of presenting things is extremely simplistic. Does not correspond to the reality and we will make a waste of all these accusations when the trial can be held under satisfactory conditions.
Maître Marcine, une dernière question, un mandat d'arrêt.
The last question. At one point, an arrest warrant was issued against your client. Then it was abandoned. His property was seized. What do you make of this? Do you judge all this? Look, the arrest warrant had been issued, but it no longer exists. And there is extreme pressure in this case. I interpret it is a clear desire to create a precedent when the French law, but also international law, does not allow France to arrogate to itself that universal jurisdiction. France has absolutely no competence to judge possible offenses committed in Equatorial Guinea. Besides, they recognize that. But it circumnavigates these prohibitions by addressing the facts solely from the point of view of money laundering, which is undoubtedly a violation of international law and an attack of the sovereignty of the Republic of Equatorial Guinea.
Ce qui constitue incontestablement une violation du droit international et une atteinte à la souveraineté de la République de Guinée équatoriale.
Thank you very much, Mr. Emmanuel Massini, for joining us on the morning call. He's Teodorin Obiang's lawyer talking to us from Paris, France. Well, it is a tough thing to be a defense lawyer in such a case, and he's given us what might happen and what is happening.